Steven Crowder apparently is launching some sort of venture, and he's put out an advertisement about it. TYT is included in it. Let's take a look at what he did with our video.
There's this right-wing blowhard named Steven Crowder.
Steven Crowder, despicable guy.
Steven Crowder, who shall be referred to as Steven Cowder.
Not only is he extremely misogynistic and sexist, he's also homophobic.
He's a disgusting garbage human being. Has been his brand from the very beginning.
Just go look at the titles of that guy's videos. Like, yeah, he's literally like the king of like saying horrible, offensive.
There's something going on with Crowder.
I fully believe this is a man that is on such a spiral. It is just shocking to me that any person cannot see exactly what he is right now.
And remember, I have not offered a word on any of it. You want something to change? It starts with love. It starts with love for the truth. But love without truth is meaningless. A love based on a lie is just that. It's a lie.
Seen all the attacks the media against Steven is because they're scared.
We are in an ideological war, and we are at a potential tipping point in this country. You need different kinds of people. You need different battalions.
How many of those people did he show his penis to in the workplace? Just curious about that.
Yeah. So mainstream media has this old trick where they would say, well, you know, the right criticizes us and the left criticizes us, so we must be doing it right. No, that could mean that you're doing it totally wrong. Right? It depends. Doesn't it depend on the facts and the issues? But Crowder here has taken it to a whole new level. He's like, no, really, everyone hates me. And hence, I must be right. I'm not sure that those things are logically connected. It's possible that you could have a bunch of bad actors be against you, and you could say, hey, I'm proud to stand up against them. But just the fact that everyone on the left and right thinks you're a douche is not a compelling ad for why you're not a douche.
But look, I mean, it seems like he's rebranding because he's trying to preach about love.
Oh, you know, it's all about love.
It starts with love.
It does.
For the truth.
And the truth, love for the truth and truth for the love, but not lies for the love or the truth, because lies are bad and it cannot be based on love. Look, guys, I write about love in my book too, so I'm no one to you know, throw stones in that direction. But when you do, you have to try to create a logical nexus. Why? Why are you talking about love? And what does that have to do with anything we're talking about? And I'll stretch here to try to get at his meaning. They all hate me, but I'm all about love. But Steven, we saw the tapes inside your house. You didn't seem like you were all about love, right?
Yeah.
But put that aside even, because I hate that stuff. I hate that it got personal. I hate that they went into his private life, etc. We've seen you on air, Steven. Not a lot of love there. Well, I mean, is that the thing you emphasize on air? Because I haven't seen it.
To be fair, he says it starts with love, and then there's a pause. Love for the truth. So,
oh, that's even worse.
What I think.
Have you ever said anything true, Steven?
What he's gonna try to do is set himself apart. I mean, like, we have our own version of this on the left with left-wing media. But he's positioning himself as like the pure one, right? I'm the real conservative here. All of these, you know, Daily Wire, they're covering for big tech. That's his big argument, right? Like, he's positioning himself as the honest one, which I would venture to say is a difficult thing to do when you literally have members of your staff like leaking to the press the kind of behavior you're engaged in. And by the way, it starts with love for the truth. You're putting a muzzle on your current staff and avoiding, like, preventing them from even conversing, having any type of relationship with former staff who have been speaking to the press about the kind of workplace environment you foster. So yeah, if you really love the truth, then why don't you tell us some honesty about what's going on in the workplace, what kind of environment you fostered, and more importantly, be honest with yourself, Steven. Like, clearly there's something going on with you.
Yeah.
So deal with that.
So look, we talked about this earlier in the show in regards to Marianne Williamson, who was on the program a little while earlier. So when there's the office leaks that come, I'm pretty skeptical about those in general, because that's a easy way to attack almost anyone in politics and media, etc. So facts matter. So that's why we looked at the facts in a bunch of cases, and we're like, I don't think there's anything there, right? On a bunch of stories. With, and by the way, left wing and right wing. But for Crowder, you can't send pictures of your penis to staff repeatedly. That's like sexual harassment 101. The very first line in the very first page of sexual harassment is, do not send pictures of your penis to your employees if you're the boss. And do not do it repeatedly, no matter whether they're guys or girls. In this case, they were guys. And it's not like, joking. The guy said, we're really uncomfortable. He kept doing these Bible studies where we talk about how Abraham would stroke the thighs of his followers and stuff. And like it got super weird. So I mean, if that's the kind of love you're talking about, also not a good idea. Also not a good idea. But even if you like say, okay, look, I don't believe anything that's ever said about anyone on the right wing because I love the right wing, etc. But this is an intra right wing fight, right? So, and that's why I thought the ad actually had one thing that was interesting. Of course, filled with ironically lies. That whole ode to truth was followed by like deplatforming. Dude, you deplatformed yourself.
Totally.
Like, you had a perfectly successful show on YouTube. We're honest about it. Like, and so we don't like the content, but it was doing well. It had a lot of subscribers, right?
Right.
So then you decided to come off of YouTube and go to Rumble. YouTube didn't do that. YouTube didn't kick you out. Daily Wire didn't kick you out. Daily Wire offered you $50 million. I don't like Daily Wire. They're a right wing outlet. But you deplatformed yourself out of $50 million, and then you chose to go to Rumble. What's the deplatforming about? Well, that seems like nothing but at a minimum, a massive misdirection on your part to try to trick your audience into thinking that you're the victim. But most importantly was the clips of Alex Jones. Why? Because Anna mentioned, like, this is happening on the left too. And in the right, they're creating faction on top of faction, right? And everybody's fighting one another. And so I was wondering, like, what is Crowder's faction going to be? And Crowder is basically going with hardcore lunatic conspiracy theories. And it's not that bad a calculation. Going to Rumble, I thought, was a terrible calculation. Turning down to $50 million was a terrible calculation. But going with Alex Jones and Tucker Carlson, that's going into the heart of Looneyville. And so, for right wingers, that's not a bad calculation.
Why is this camera guy shirtless?
I don't know if they're trying to prove something there. Like, hey, we're open-minded. You see, left wing, I made my camera person strip topless.
Listen, I fancy myself a pretty open-minded gal, okay? Don't need to see any shirtless men here at work. No offense to you guys, it's just not a professional thing to be doing in the workplace.
No, guys, like they have a workplace. He got offered $50 million. Obviously, they make a lot of money, right? You have to run a real company.
Can you imagine?
No, the idea that Craig, one of our stage managers, would walk in here.
Craig, like, walking
without
in.
Without a shirt.
Without a shirt.
Like we'd be like, what? Okay, like, sorry, Craig, that I use you as an example, just because you weren't here. Okay, seriously. We love Craig. He would never do that, because that's mental, right? But I think in their warped right wing mind, they think like, oh, you see that? We're open to everybody. That dude shows up in no shirt and gold sprinkles or whatever the hell was on his body, and we're open to it. And then they still criticize us. No, keep your clothes on at work. Easy rule.
It starts with love.
Unless you have the kind of job that requires you to not keep your clothes on.
Okay, well, hey,
you
know? To each his own, right?
Exactly.
So, okay.
All right.
It starts with love.
Does it? Okay. And he's doing that ad because ain't nobody gonna watch on Rumble. Okay, so yeah, he'll get a bunch of people. But look, the Alex Jones strategy is not a bad one. If you're gonna pick a faction among the right wing, who's gonna get more? I'm not saying votes, right? Although probably votes too. But online followers and people who wanna watch you, the more radical you go, the crazier you go, especially in the right wing, the bigger the audience you're gonna get is. So that's what, in that case, my job is to be honest and give you real analysis. I think that even though I hate it, and I think it's even crazier than the other right wingers, being crazier in the right wing is the correct strategy. Thanks for watching the Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges, You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.